We're going to demonstrate how to use the NIGHTSEA fluorescence adapter system with the Keyence VHX series with the ZST lens. A fluorescence system consists of just a couple key elements. Excitation light sources that produce the right wavelengths of light to excite the fluorescence, and barrier filters that block the reflected excitation light, in this case from reaching the camera, but transmit the emitted fluorescence. So NIGHTSEA does this with modular light heads for the different wavelengths. Each one is matched with a custom-made barrier filter that's going to mount in the Keyence. And we also supply a matching pair of barrier filter glasses for each one for user convenience and safety. So the barrier filter is common to the different ways of installing it, so we're going to show that first. The barrier filter is in a custom holder. It only goes in one way. It does say top on it. So you remove the rubber cap covering the analyzer port, position the filter there, and just push it in. It should go in fairly easily, and just push it until it stops, and it can just live in there while you're doing fluorescence. For the light source, there are two options of applying the excitation. At lower magnifications, with fairly flat subjects that don't have a lot of shadowing and relief, it seems to be better in general to mount the excitation source right on the end of the NIGHTSEA gooseneck and then position it. It may take a little bit of jockeying, but to position it so it's illuminating your subject from the side. At higher magnifications, or if you have a lot of shadowing, we have a provision for mounting the excitation light source directly on the Keyence fiber optic input port. So we remove the Keyence fiber, lifting straight up, and we can park it out of the way at the slot up at the top. Just bring it up there, line up the white dots, put it in place, and that can live up there out of the way. In order to put the light source over the mount, we have over the fiber input, we have a custom mount that just slips on over there and pushes down, and just secure it very lightly with a thumb screw. And then the light heads will mount in that, but in order to get the electricity to the light heads, we have a cable. One end plugs into the gooseneck, the other end plugs into the connector on the light head. We can then insert that into the spot, tighten the thumb screw lightly, and that's now ready to go.